Amplitronic. Listen to the difference.
Hi, I'm James from Amplitronic, and I'm here to talk to you today about the continued relevance of telecoils and hearing loops. Assistive listening systems have been widely available since the 1930s, the most successful of which has been the hearing loop and telecoil combination. This partnership has given hearing aid and cochlear implant users access to audio in many areas which would normally be uncomfortably noisy or unintelligible, including theatres, lecture halls, places of worship, retail and customer service counters, help points, digital displays, and even on mass transport systems.
There are a lot of misconceptions about hearing loops. To my mind, never has a great piece of tech been so misunderstood, badly treated, and wrongly dismissed. A good hearing loop can make the listening experience so much more restful and pleasant, even if you've got great hearing aids. It's especially effective if the T setting is programmed fully to the hearing loop, so you're protected from the scraping chairs and other extraneous environmental noise. And I've encouraged all sorts of people to try them and find that they become fans quite easily when they experience a good one. And in some situations, they are a bit of help, but in others, they are absolutely invaluable. And the positive experiences of why there are groups and individuals actively out there checking hearing loops and making sure more good ones are available. It would be terrific if audiologists could tell people about hearing loops. And probably more helpful still if more audiology clinics had top-notch hearing loops available so people had the chance to experience what they're like.
There are some exciting developments in future assistive listening technology starting to emerge. However, there's significant confusion amongst hearing aid users and facility providers, many of whom, for example, expect current Bluetooth technology to provide the same access to audio in venues and public facilities as hearing loops, which of course it doesn't. Let's remind ourselves of the unique benefits which hearing loops offer.
I'm Simon Lewis. I'm a hearing aid user and have been for pretty much all my life. And I'm here to say that I've used pretty much every assistive listening technology that's around. I love them all. I love the fact that so much is being done in the technology. But when it comes down to it, for social reasons, for technological reasons, simply sometimes just for sheer lack of embarrassment, loop systems are the things which I default to pretty much every single time. Going to cinema or to a theatre and having to book out equipment is difficult. Trying to wear pendants and whatever, although they can provide good solutions, it's just something that's on your body all the time. Being able to walk into a church or theatre and simply just tap a button on the aid and getting direct sound straight away, that really works every time.
In addition, there appears to be a common misconception among both hearing aid users and facility providers that relatively few hearing aids are now telecoil equipped. In fact, a recent review of the connectivity of over 750 hearing aid model variants showed that 38% had a telecoil fitted as standard and a further 42% had a telecoil as an option. Furthermore, the 2019 NHS Supply Chain Framework Agreement for hearing aids and custom ear molds states that a telecoil must be offered as standard on all behind-the-ear hearing aids. It's fair to say that the significant majority of UK-dispensed hearing aids remain telecoil-equipped. However, hearing loops are certainly not a new invention. So, could loops and telecoils be replaced soon? To answer that question, the International Hearing Access Committee, representing a number of leading hearing organisations, stated in June 2019 that it is reasonable to believe that telecoils, hearing loops, and assistive listening solution usage will continue for the next 10 to 15 years and beyond. The key difficulty associated with replacing hearing loops is that the telecoil itself is hard to replace. Telecoils are passive, they consume no additional battery power. They're very low cost, they're part of a non-proprietary open standard, and they're easy to use. In addition, they have no latency or delay issues, and there's already a large install base of telecoil-equipped hearing aids. Before hearing loop technology can be replaced, all the stakeholders must agree on a new technology that could provide universal access. it must meet most, if not all, of the benefits offered by the telecoil. This isn't easy, both technically and with many stakeholders having their own commercial interests. Once the standard is agreed and published, the new technology needs to be integrated into new hearing aids, and these devices must become commonplace. There'll be a considerable crossover period during which the existing technology, loops, will remain relevant because of the high volume of installed systems and a significant proportion of hearing aids not yet having the new connectivity. This whole process is likely to be measured in years. To set realistic expectations, the International Hearing Access Committee powerfully stated, "Hearing aid and cochlear implant users require continued quality hearing access in public places, which is currently and in the foreseeable future provided by telecoils and hearing loop and assistive listening solutions. The rights of users to access must be continued and maintained during this period of technological change and shall not be compromised by the promise and overly optimistic expectations of a future technology development." Thousands of hearing loop systems are installed by UK businesses and service providers every year as part of their legal obligations to provide fair access to audio for those with hearing issues. However, a 2018 Eurotrack study of the UK hearing aid sector reported that only 22% of recipients had been informed about hearing aid accessories by their healthcare provider. Therefore, on behalf of our customers who seek to provide access to their facilities to hearing aid users, we're seeking a renewed commitment from the hearing instrument manufacturing and dispensing community to raise awareness and improve the quality of access to audio for all hearing aid users. So, what can you as audiologists do to help? Ensure that your patients, customers, and clients are aware of the benefits of telecoils and loops. Tell them what to look out for that will signal that an assistive listening solution is available. Show them how to use the T setting on their hearing aid. Encourage them to complain when an assistive listening solution isn't available. And have your procurement teams demand telecoil-enabled hearing aids from the manufacturers. Thanks for listening today. For an information pack on hearing loops and other assistive listening technologies, please visit www.ampatronic.com.
Ampatronic. Listen to the difference.